When your GPA falls below 2.0, you'll get yourself in trouble. You might be placed in probation, suspension, or even dismissal. So what is GPA and how to calculate it? That's exactly what this video is all about. Stay with me until the end and I'll show you what's the impact when you fail a course and how you can save your GPA before it's too late. GPA stands for Grade Point Average. It's a number that shows how well you're doing in all your classes throughout the term. There are two types, weighted and unweighted. This video will focus on the unweighted GPA. This means the difficulty of your courses will not be considered. Whether you get an A in an easy or challenging class, it will always be a 4.0. Here's a common scale which runs from 0 to 4.0. Let's say you took chemistry, English, psychology, and math, and these are the grades that you got. Each letter grade represents a grade point. You want to check with your school for the skill that you should use. Each of the course will have a specific credit hour. Let's say as an example, chemistry is a 4 credit hour, while the rest are 3 credit hour. You can check with your school on the credit hour for each of your course. To get the credit points, you multiply the credit hour with grade points. For chemistry, it'll be 4 times 3.67 and that's 14.68. Do the same for English, 3 times 3.33 equals 9.99. Repeat the same calculations. For psychology, it's 6.00 and math, it's 9.00. Add up all the credit points, that's 39.67. Add up all the credit hours, that's 13. To calculate your GPA, divide the total credit points with the total credit hours. That's 39.67 divided by 13 and that equals 3.05. That's the GPA for this example. I've created this GPA calculator along with other useful calculators to help my Simplifiers community manage their grades. Join us for resources like this. Link is in the description box. Now, let's say you've had a rough semester with chemistry and you're about to end up with an F. Look at the impact on your GPA. This is bad news because you're going to end up with a GPA of 1.92. This translates to you're going to be in trouble. So what can you do? Drop the course if it's possible. Look at what happens to your GPA once you drop chemistry. It went up from 1.92 to 2.78 and you're safe. Thumbs up if you find this helpful. Once you've studied more than one semester, you'll also want to calculate your CGPA. I talk about it here in this video. Here are the other calculations you might be interested in.